That's scary.
So what happened?
Sailor Dan is in the house.
Yeah, I went in because I was a little bit numb one day and I had gout going on. So you got
we'll save it for the podcast. Save it for a show.
I hadn't seen the doctor.
Did you bring your file and we could review? We'll have to sign a HIPAA agreement.
You guys are handsome.
Dan, put your headphones on.
Who are you? Reggie Dunlop, the coach.
I saw Jim, but I forgot to ask him about the mic. We gotta get you a mic.
Hey, try not to shoot that puck up my pooper. Yeah, but check out this guy on the Bruins. He says, I'll shoot the puck anywhere I want. And if that happens to be in your pooper, so be it.
Then I'm totally
committed.
This way,
what's that? Once a week. You're not committing to much. Nobody listens anyway.
Chris Chelios. On Jeff Hackett, low to the stick side. Great individual effort.
And now, from the hockey capital of the world, Park Ridge, Illinois.
Make sure I lean back.
It's the Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
Is that now, smelling trash,
he is,
burning trash
the
bags?
Hockey man with the plan. That bacon frying
hey,
fool.
Terry, if you see
host,
me on fire, let me know.
You got it.
From deep underground, the broadcast bunker.
I'll take your place on the plane.
We got a full house today. And my name is Action Jackson. And with me, as always, is Sexy Terry.
Sailor Dan is back from his anal problems.
That's right. Professor Ken.
And Michael is drinking.
Yes.
Giddy up, good listeners.
And Rookie Mike.
Hello.
And back from death's door, ladies and gentlemen, Sailor Dan has returned to us once again.
He still doesn't have a mic.
He doesn't have a mic, so he'll sound quiet.
We can do a duet on this one. You want to get over here? And
I'm sorry, what?
There you go. Even better. Look at that.
Like that's never happened before.
Well, we just survived Valentine's Day. Dan survived a trip to the hospital, and Rookie Mike survived a month without drinking, and now he's drinking.
Woo-hoo!
And Kenny's not plugged into the his
come on, Kenny.
Me
suck. What kind of engineer are you?
Now I'm trying to figure this out.
Said it before. I'll say it again. God, I miss Jim.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no shit. So do I.
All right, so
like Casey Jones, the one that crashed into the.
So you will have to share the mic with Dan because we want to hear about a story at the hospital stay. So you thought you were having, a heart attack?
I didn't think I was having a heart attack, no.
So why were you in there?
Because the doctor told me to go to the emergency room. He didn't like what he saw on the EKG.
And you were there overnight and...
No, you know what? The first night, it was the daddy-daughter dance thing, right?
I saw the picture. Very cute.
Yeah, so...
Yes.
I'm like, I saw you there. Remember,
I'm
like, what the hell's going
look,
on here?
There's nothing wrong with me. You told me my blood work is fine. Everything is fine. The EKG is much different than it was at the doctor's office. You got to let me go. You're not holding me the whole weekend so I could do a test on Monday. You got to let me go. I have this thing tonight.
Right.
So they let me go. So I went Monday morning to do the stress test, and then they admitted me. Thought I had a blockage. There was no blockage. It's fine. I'm happy camper. Help.
So was it just gas or...
He had an M&M wedged in there.
It was a bit of Polish, just lads.
He had a Maxwell Street Polish, right?
An army soldier.
Yeah.
No, that's out the other end.
Right. On the right side, you know.
Well, we're happy.
Welcome back, buddy.
We're happy. There was nothing serious about you, Dan.
Absolutely.
Terry sent the pictures of the army men when he heard what you had going on.
Yeah, that was funny. I mean, I was laughing my ass off, and I would have called.
Well, then we called you from the podcast,
right there,
and you were in the.
Yeah, not a good idea.
Why not? It's always a good. It's always a good idea to call people's wives. Let's call Kristen right now.
Yes, Rookie Mike is heading off to sunny
Punta Cana.
That's right.
Yes.
Where he can buy illegal pharmaceuticals and pina coladas.
So what time you take off in the morning?
Early. 7.
That's early.
You need a ride to the airport?
No, I don't think so.
Are girls going too?
I got to drop the girls off at our friend's house at 7, and then because they have one in junior high, one in grade school, they're going to take them to school, and then we'll go. But I appreciate it, Terry. Thank you.
That's Terry, always thinking.
Always looking out for everybody.
I was going to say, Christina would probably be more than happy to take it.
Yeah, sure. As long as Kenny stays out of the house.
We got a new Twitter follower. New Twitter
If Terry would figure out how to shovel, I wouldn't have that problem.
That's why I have boys for.
Yes.
You know, so they don't shovel.
So that you can complain when they don't shovel. Well, we got a new Twitter follower. It's Webchicks, and that's a bunch of nice
pictures?
Young ladies. Oh, yeah. Many, many, many. Aren't they? They're the friendliest gals I've ever seen. Thanks for following us, Webchicks.
We love the Webchicks.
Yes. We're on some mailing list, I guess, where we either get people from China or porn sites checking us out.
I'm gonna hand Kenny's cards out when I'm down in
Kenny, two of our favorite people.
Kenny, you're gonna have to pot that up by about 900% there.
Was it actually going through this time?
Barely.
All right. I'm still working something through. You guys keep carrying on amongst yourselves.
Kenny,
you do hand out some of my
you wanna pass those around there? Sailor
Dan? What?
My business cards.
I will. Like who's this? I don't know. What the hell he's talking about? I'm sure it's Spanish or.
You ever had that before? Yeah. That's very good.
That sounds even worse. I think it fixed
the connection.
Wow. Oh my god. Yeah. Good thing I had my hat on.
There we go.
Okay. Now back.
Thank you, Dan. Thank you, Dan. All right. Yes, well, that cleared it all out, didn't it? The any cobwebs you may have had.
Just like Terry's heater up there.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, sir, this isn't Buffalo Trace, is it?
Mm-hmm.
That would be Buffalo Trace again.
It's delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, you know what I got?
Thank you.
Is that Buffalo Trace, Terry? Little plug.
Thank you.
Little plug for how do I get that to
for
stop?
Your butt.
Let's not ring the bell unless they actually give us more.
That's how you get it, though, Jackie.
Oh, okay. Buffalo Trace, good for the good people at Lexington.
Normally,
Kentucky.
We get it when I pay for it.
Yes. All right, well, here, toast to Sailor Dan returning to us.
In his health.
In his health.
Now, what about last week? Was it really a colon issue?
It was a 17
Dan,
degrees.
Welcome back.
Welcome back, Dan.
No, it's too goddamn cold last week.
Welcome back, Michael. I'm happy you're drinking.
Hey, now.
Welcome back to drinking.
That really is good stuff.
I got to tell you, now that I'm wearing my quilted, Kenny pants, I'm comfy as heck now.
I can, I got the Call of Duty.
You got Zubas on?
Yeah. No, they're not Zubas. They're like these bib overall things. I'm not wearing shoes or,
Jesus Christ, not here, Ken.
I got the
Professor Ken's
Call of Duty.
Removing his pants and showing us his Call of Duty fleece underwears.
I'll tell you what, those things are warm.
Oh, yeah.
Very nice.
I like.
Was that Velcro?
I woke up.
Was that Velcro that I heard?
On my pants, it is. I woke up the other morning and fell asleep in the chair. Woke up
those
to Borat.
Kenny walks off. Ready, Lori? Rips them off.
Oh, yeah, tearaway.
Yeah, damn right. Yeah.
Tearaway boxers.
Like, you're like the Harlem Globetrotters, right?
Kenny's an empty nester now. The kids are gone. Time to play.
Kelly's still around.
She's still alive.
Yeah, she doesn't care, though.
She would if she saw me naked running through the house, I think.
Most people would.
I think anyone would.
Yeah, I have to forget that.
He sits out in his yurt naked. Yeah.
The 16-year-old's in town, and Daddy can't walk around with his wiener hanging out nearly as often as I used to. So,
thank you.
She don't like that.
You don't pull the shades, the neighbors thank you.
I don't care about you guys.
The 16-year-old should be in town more often.
Panarin scored.
All right. Hawks are kicking some ass tonight.
It's Toronto.
I went Saturday night.
The shittiest team in the whole wide world.
It's the Hawks against the Wolves.
Yeah. Pretty much.
I went Saturday night to that three-two overtime loss.
Kenny, did you call in with your intermission report?
I did, if Terry's network will allow me in here.
Probably not.
I will.
You could have met up with Kristen. She was there.
She and Brittany were taking pictures of each other for 3 hours straight.
Ooh, that could be interesting.
Of the same picture.
In the Sonia Henney room.
Oh.
Yeah.
Got to post those.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty good.
It's good, isn't it?
Buffalo
yeah.
Trace?
Yes.
It's
yes.
good. It's good.
Yes, it's very good.
This is our flavor of the day at work right now.
It's
That was drank all last week.
What's that?
The missing Dan formation.
Oh, yeah. There's some spilled on the ground. For
the
you,
bison.
Dan, somewhere around here.
Bison trace.
Yeah.
I guess I'll buy a microphone this week.
Well, now that's now springtime's coming around. It's gonna be a balmy 35 degrees.
So Mike, he was out here while it was cold. He's already paid his dues.
Well, it's supposed to be 50 by the end of the week.
I'm not paying more than $10.
Nor should. No, yeah, exactly.
Bring one that's like connected to the speaking spell.
Yeah, I'll get one of those.
Hello.
See, sound like one of the ones you put up to your neck.
It'll sound like
Cancer Gazoo.
Violet the Bombardier. Yeah, the throat mics.
Throat mics.
That's what they're called. Yeah, yeah, they're like attached to your neck.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Your grandfather probably wore one in WW2 there, Mikey.
He probably did.
This is the Navigator.
Never get
Hank
the bomb there.
This is the Navigator that shot our communication antenna off.
Drop.
Yeah.
We're good to go. Good to go. Oops.
Whoopsie. That's a design flaw of the airplane.
So, Mikey, you take off tomorrow. When are you coming back?
Saturday.
Oh, late very Saturday. Nice.
Should be nice. Nice to get away.
Punta Cana? Is it like one of these trips that someone won?
No.
Like
just
a work trip? No.
It's, we paid for it.
Nice. You go down with a group of people?
Krista and I.
Just the
that's
two
good.
Of you? That's
yeah.
it?
That's a good thing.
No, that's nice.
For the whole weekend?
For
the whole
week. Just till Saturday.
Alone?
You believe it?
Holy fuck.
I know. Yeah,
I don't think we've gone anywhere, just us two, for years. I mean, we always
take
kids.
Yeah, that's what happens, right?
Chaka, chaka.
Yeah, think of the things you won't have to argue about. That's all the Heather and I just argue about the kids or whatever, because they ruin everything.
Good for you.
Kids. Listen to this here in a couple of years. Kids, they ruin everything.
They do. I mean, they have their benefits.
Those damn kids, they ruin everything.
It would be a lot easier without the kids.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I mean, you know, the only thing we argued about when we went to Cancun is let's go down for a drink. She's like, it's 9. Can't we see something? I said, we'll see the bar.
Yeah, we'll see the bar. And we'll see the pool.
There's another goal, 5.
That didn't go over.
Keener.
So
wow.
Just shanked one right in.
Yeah,
breakaway.
I said this
shot
before we
running.
Started, but I believe that the Maple Leafs are worse with the Mike Babcock.
They don't have any players.
All right, we got the cock reference.
Yeah, but he got rid of Kessel. They got rid of Dion Phaneuf. They got rid of another.
What's the guy's name? Mike Babtaint?
Babcock.
Taint and cock in within a minute.
We got to get it in.
Get it in there. Get the
bacon. Oh, there it is.
Rookie Mike, yeah. Not, no, please note in the log. Oh, look at that.
Oh, there that. Sniped it. Watch his little wrister.
Little wristy.
Look at this. Ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, nice shot.
Put in a stick side upper corner. It's
Reimer's
got to
be like, oh, fuck.
Yeah.
This guy.
Yeah, they stink. They stink.
This would have been a better game.
So
do
you like these, Jackie?
I like it a lot, actually. This is my favorite one of the...
Today.
Today?
This is my favorite cigar I've had today.
No, actually, it's very good. For those listening at home, I'm smoking a PDR 1878 Kappa Sun Grown cigar supplied to me by my good friend Sexy Terry, and it's delicious.
And Daniel has a...
Dan's got a,
Alec Bradley?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Alec Bradley Sun Grown,
yes,
also
yes,
very
ladies
good.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Bacon Hockey and Cigar
those
podcast.
Those are good.
And Kenny is looking up donkey porn quietly.
What are you doing over here, Kenny?
Bestiality.
It's
well,
hard
I
to find these
up.
Days, but when you know where to look.
Kenny's very quiet.
I'm trying sometimes to you gotta, you know, you gotta go to Japan and Germany for that special stuff that Kenny likes. Sometimes
now,
you know,
now I know why he switched to a left-handed
sometimes
mouse.
Sometimes Mexico will provide with a little bit of
those
know.
Dick fingers going 2 miles an hour.
Now it all makes sense.
Left-handed mouse sure does make sense. And the carpal tunnel.
Why is my password not correct?
Uh-oh.
Somebody's hacked into our voicemail.
Did you spell taint wrong?
It's T-A-Y-N-T.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
Oh, man. What, do we got some voicemail?
It's like Janus, right? The same way.
Right, yes.
Can't spell.
Well, that was a tactical error on your part because you knew that he.
Give it to Dan. See.
Okay, Dan. Here's the.
Yeah.
One of those things is not like the other. Well,
those are the top shutout people.
Yes.
Overall for goalies, hockey. Yeah, but just if you read like, read from like number 5 down to 9.
Into the
like
mic.
The names.
Into the mic.
Yeah, into the mic. Like the names.
The name from 5 to 9.
Yeah.
Jacques Plante.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Jacques Plante. You got to turn towards the mic though.
Dominic. I can't see it.
Hasek.
You want my glasses?
Yeah. Dominic Hasek, Tiny Thompson, Hugh, Giannis.
See, Mike, you are
Hugh
just
Giannis.
You are just a goofball.
He's reading. It's Hugh Janus.
Thank you, Dan.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dan.
Hugh Janus.
So he's trying to be all French Canadian.
Yeah, I mean Giannis.
Yeah.
Way to go, Dan.
Jay, you want to pass more to that Buffalo Trace down here?
Yeah,
you want to hear the voicemails?
Yeah, we sure do, Kenny.
Nice, Dan, ruined that one.
Let's see how this one
I
works.
Thought it was just Kenny.
Kenny ruined it last week.
I gotta be like Mike Hunt.
Yeah. Heywood, did you blow me?
You're calling in from the United Center Live in the Blackhawks Anaheim Ducks game where the score is 0-0. The Ducks are out shooting the Blackhawks right now 11-7. What was interesting is the Ducks started out shooting them 2-0. Then it was 6 straight shots on goal for the Blackhawks, followed by 9 straight shots on goal by the.
It's gonna come.
Ducks.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Your hot hawk fast.
Highly engineered show.
That Corey Crawford,
professional grade broadcasting.
Hey, Mal.
Stay tuned and listen in for a second period update. As we hope that the Blackhawks find some kind of life and put something together and get this sloppy first period behind them. Talk to you later. Giddy up, good listeners.
God, Mike, what the fuck?
I didn't get that wax, Simmer.
Simmer.
He's already on vacation. Is Mike drinking again?
Yeah, I like the non-drinking Mike now.
I'm beginning to think that the sober Mike ain't so bad.
Oh man, Dan, you should. You were there for some of the sober Mike. He was
sober crabby Mike.
He's tense.
Now he's sloppy drunk. Now he's sloppy drunk Mike.
I was the reason of well-being.
You lost a bunch of weight. That's good on you.
Yeah,
I found it.
I need to do that.
Let's see if this sounds better.
Hey, Bacon and Hack.
No.
Fans.
I mean, if we're
going
to do it again, we all stop doing the same time.
Stop doing what?
If we do, do it all at the same time.
Stop what?
Stop
drinking? Are you nuts?
That's what I'm saying.
Bacon and Sobriety Podcast.
What's going on here?
Kenny's got some. He's got a wire.
Kenny's got issues.
I don't know.
It's your wire.
I'm trying to see if I can
fiddle with the wire. Not the plug, but the wire.
That's his damn new operating system bullshit.
SAP software?
It doesn't like this out.
Can we review that, Ken? Can we do that little snippet he did that one time with
the
software? Remember the whole
every statistic?
The Germans?
Yeah, that was the SAP.
Yeah. He's talking. All
right, are you done fiddling around, Kenny?
No, these were. I think these were quality.
Hawks got a double major, double minor.
From the United Center again. I hope you all are enjoying the contest tonight. These live intermission updates have been brought to you by Greek Islands Restaurant, located conveniently.
Opa!
I got a free pita.
You get a free appetizer?
I got a free pita.
A free pita, an extra pita with this kebab.
That's about what we rate is free pitas.
I don't know who this
I'd be
one.
Happy with a free pita.
I like that.
I don't know who this one is.
All right, let's hear it. Turn. Yeah, the Saganaki. All right, Kenny.
Let's see what we got.
Yeah, hi, Terry.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Ken. Hey, I just wanted you to make sure that you noted tonight during the podcast that February 15th is officially the National Flag of Canada Day. That's today, February 15th.
Yeah.
I expect to hear mention of it on the podcast.
There you go.
Do I have the flag of Canada?
Happy Flag Day, Canada. Yeah. I have a Quebec flag. I don't know if I have the proper Canadian one.
No.
I'm sorry for all our Canadian listeners. I do not have the Canada flag.
We should.
We should have the Canada flag in here.
We are friends to Canada and Sexy Terry's.
No, we
people.
Have to have an American flag first and foremost.
We got
a couple American flags in here.
Oh, we got to hang it.
Yeah, we got to hang
all
it.
All right, well, next weekend I'll have both flags on.
We need to have one of those little things, like the little flags, like the UN.
Yes, that represent the different nations.
The different nations that listen to our
podcast. The delegate from Botswana would like to talk. He has to comment on the Kane's goal streak and how it affects trade relations in South Central Africa.
Leathery Mansack, did you figure out how to get into your mail?
No.
Look at that.
Because you sent something to Action.
No, I did not.
Look at that.
It says from Leathery Mansack.
No, it would be from Douche McGraw.
I hope that she's a. I
wonder
she's
if it's
a,
from our friend at CamGirl13 or whatever it is.
I hope she's a listener. Let's put it that way.
I can't wait.
Go read it, Kenny. What does it say?
Oh, it was just a picture.
Yes.
It was.
Oh, web chicks. I'm sorry, web chicks. Hello. Find beautiful adults for sex dating. That doesn't sound American at all. Sex dating. We would like to make sex dating with you.
I'd like to sex date you.
That's a Dieter. Remember him from Saturday Night Live?
Yeah.
Do, 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 do.
Yeah. Do, do, do. Your story's grown tiresome.
I feel like a little girl.
Yeah, hang on. I got that right here. Well, Ken is a busy
engineering the show.
Engineering the show.
He's hardcore engineering.
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's what I'm talking about. There we go. Another goal.
Again?
Yeah.
Oh
look at
that.
Table.
6-0.
That was a 2-man advantage.
Well, he should score on that.
Yeah, now scored another one.
Is this at home?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Babcock's over there. Freaking
shit. You guys stink. I'm going back to Detroit.
He wishes he never left Detroit.
That's not what I wanted.
That's the NFL.
That's Europe.
No, that's the final countdown.
Europe.
Jesus. That's the NFL.
Yeah, that's
telling
what they start
shit.
Out with.
All right, here we go.
Off the glove.
There's no defense whatsoever.
Hello, welcome to Bacon and Hockey Podcast in Germany.
Eesh.
Hello, welcome to Sprockets.
Sprockets.
I am Professor Ken, your host.
Hi.
I cry.
Would you like to touch my monkey?
Oh, there's Dan. Dan's driving in. Dan and his spastic colon.
Or half of it anyway.
Your story has grown tiresome. All right, there we go.
Kenny, would you like some buffalo trace?
Sure. Maybe he needs some. Maybe it'll help.
Well, I'll tell you what, I had a lot of shit to set up today. I mean, I got to send the bunker crew in. I don't know what happened to it. Mike took
why?
It.
What?
No.
What are you looking for?
My shot glass.
That was mine from last week.
Here, have another one.
It's right there.
This is fine china.
Here we go. Found it.
Wow. It's so uneventful. But the went to the game Saturday night.
Yeah.
And what was interesting is on the professor's Facebook page is the 1 year ago today thing came up.
Yes.
It was me at the Blackhawk game.
Oh, I did see that.
And I was like, hey, that's cool.
With the wife. That's a nice tradition. You and Lori at the...
Yeah, it's her birthday weekend.
Oh, that's sweet.
That's nice.
Another goal.
I got her a...
Holy shit.
Well, I even gave it to the guy who never plays.
Is that
the new guy?
I think it was John Scott.
You know, I just saw something on Bleacher Report that said he's heading back to... the Brunswick, whatever.
Bowling alley.
I don't know. I think he was off because his wife had kids, maybe. Mm-hmm. I think she
twins.
Was pregnant. Twins,
who?
Right?
Twins, John Scott.
Mrs. Scott. Mrs. Scott, bless her.
Jesus.
Congratulations.
Cheers, gentlemen.
Cheers to you, Kitty.
Great engineering work this
and
week.
To John, and to John Scott's new twins.
Yes.
Congratulations.
Here's to the Hawks are up a touchdown.
Yeah, they did score.
Right. Wow, they are smoking these guys.
Oh, good. We needed it after.
Is that I've got the goalie. Is that going to hurt my goals against?
no, it'll be fine.
No, you're good.
They're keeping him in. They're not pulling him. I don't know why. Because
there's no one else.
What else?
Because the other goalie left.
Yeah, he had to.
He's like, I don't want any part of this shit.
He's at Rickle Benny's right now.
Yeah.
Hey, give me a breaded steak sandwich.
He's at the Cobra Lounge right now. Wow. Well, that's good. It's so good. I mean, it's too bad it's Toronto that we're beating the shit out. It'd be nice if it was Anaheim or.
We need to get back on.
A team that we actually gives a, you know, that isn't gunning for a draft pick at this point.
The next game I will be at is against Dallas on March 22nd, I believe.
There we go.
I'm going to the Ice Hogs Wolves this Saturday.
Very nice.
This guy's taunting now?
Was thinking about sporting my Blackhawks attire, but maybe not. And
to where?
The next Sunday matinee game, going to that game too.
The Wolves?
The Blackhawks. I got like four games in the next 2 months.
Wow.
Something like
that's what, 11:30 game?
Yeah, Sunday
that's
one.
Nice one.
That's a nice one.
That's where I first saw Not Your Father's Root Beer. I went to the Ogden, and we were having, she had a Bloody Mary or whatever, and I had a beer.
Was that the 27th?
Sounds
okay.
Yeah. It might be the 28th.
You know, Not Your Father's. Right,
root beer float.
They have a ginger ale.
Right, for
now,
the rest
too.
Of you guys, if it's a nice day out. Blackhawks in the backyard, and I'll break out the griddle.
The griddle?
I love it.
The Sunday, the 28th?
Have you guys
February.
Been to the Ogden? It's good.
I like the Ogden, except service sometimes blows. You got to get there kind of early. It's hard to get a seat sometimes. And
what street is it on?
It takes a full hour plus to get out of there.
Is it on Ogden?
Yeah. Where's it at? Ogden and what?
It's right
at Madison. No, not Madison, Monroe.
Oh.
I went there before the Sabbath concert.
And Monroe is just like a side street right there.
Yeah.
It's not even a real street. But we park underneath the bridge right there, just down from the Ogden.
Over by
there. On the street, over by there.
You going to ACDC tomorrow night?
No.
Where are they playing at?
UC.
I would love to, but the ticket is outrageous.
I had tickets, and...
I may go see The Who.
Well, I had my line on tickets, because they're at the UC, so I get the... Whatchamacallit tonight.
Lexi texted.
I was already gone.
Lexi texted me. She's looking for somebody to go to Black Sabbath in Vegas.
Ooh, when they going?
Damn.
I forget when
are they
in Vegas? I think it's summer or fall.
I'm in Vegas from, let me see, what am I? Is it like the 10th to the 13th?
Do you and your wife, I see why you're going on a trip. You're just wanting to see her for a change. You guys, she's in Canada.
I'm going to
you're in
Vegas.
Vegas.
I'm
you're
going
in
buddies.
Dallas. You're in...
How I do it.
That is how he does it.
I go to the Splains.
Yeah.
These
no,
guys.
You go to the
I go to
fucking,
my den.
You go to the fucking Dells.
You're in Wisconsin every
Yeah, we'll be in Wisconsin this weekend. Yeah.
I heard about that news last night. Some Illinois guy drove his snowmobile into the pond at Lake Geneva. I thought it was you. Make sure your car was
Well, they were parking cars on Lake Geneva.
I know.
You hear about that?
Idiots.
It was like 20 cars.
Oh,
yeah.
That was during the... They have
like,
a big...
Like a Winterfest or something like that.
They have ice sculpting and all the other stuff.
They parked the cars at a lake.
And then ice melted. What?
Whoops.
Whoops.
Idiot.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Sorry, dear. Apparently the ice is a little bit too...
Maybe 2 inches of ice ain't enough, eh?
Can I get a beer from you guys?
You want one of these?
Yeah, no. I got beer down here, dude.
I want a Miller Lite. I'm easing in.
Yeah. Here, I got a High Life Lite.
So what are you going to drink down in Punta Cana?
I don't know where it was there. It's all inclusive, but...
What the fuck are you doing? Jesus Christ.
Lucky Mike is a...
You remember...
Good thing I got a trash bag on.
Do you remember the...
You can just turn it inside out and put everything inside.
That, sir, spills a lot today.
Do you remember the... I think it's still on the website, too, listeners. You might want to check it out, www.bacon.hockey.com.
That one? I was loaded.
Where you spit it up.
Oh, that was bad.
Where is
the...
I was compromised.
He's
that
back
night.
On the back off the wagon.
Yeah, way to go, guys.
Welcome back, Michael.
Yeah, see.
Oh, fuck, it's hot. I just leaned back and like, holy shit. Man.
Your hefty bag's on fire.
Oh, man. He's Rookie Mike is inches
You're
away
a mess.
From the propane heater
dying
there.
Over here.
Oh, yeah.
God damn it.
Kenny. What are you doing, Kenny?
This is the worst podcast ever.
Oh, we've had worse than this.
Oh, I don't know about it. There's no content.
That's better.
Do we ever have content?
That's better.
You okay now?
Sure we do.
All right.
Well, somebody keeps fucking with all the levels, and I got to fucking re-engineer the whole goddamn board every time.
I believe he was looking
time.
Right at you.
Who's best with levels?
Oh,
we don't want to go anywhere.
The only button I ever
Octopi.
Touched is my...
I got to pop myself down. Pop me up. Pop me up. Pop
no,
me down.
That's what he did last
pop
week.
Me
I
down.
Know.
I can't hear anything. Oh, God, it's too loud.
Well, I can control my own mic, but you pop my microphone down.
You know, that High Life light.
Jesus Christ, you have lost weight.
Yeah, look at you. You're like a... Boy, you're going to look good in the fucking banana sling.
Oh, yeah.
Pretend you're...
Just you too?
Pretend you're from Europe.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
Look at me. Look at me in my marble bag.
My bag of marbles.
My nudicle sack.
Yes, yes.
Are those nudicles?
Oh, I'm looking forward to the foot for the candid photography.
Oh,
yeah. Kristen goes to me. He goes, do you want to bring your phone? I'm like, no. Like, I'll bring my... I'm not going to have it on. She's like, do you want a plan so you can... I'm like, the
plan
only
what?
People... So I can use my phone down there? I'm like, no.
No, why
so
would you?
The only people that ever use... Only time I ever get anything is either a text from Kenny...
You don't
you
get... No.
Or Kristen...
Yeah.
And phone calls for work.
Right.
You know,
I don't
fuck
want my
you.
Phone.
Fuck
I'm
you.
I'm like,
is
I'm gonna spend $60
say.
Bucks so I can get Ken's text when I'm in Dominican.
Oh, God damn it! Find me the right fucking. Find me the right goddamn.
I like 40 all right, messages.
Okay, so
38 are from Ken.
So instead, hey, instead
what are you
of,
doing?
Instead of texting Mike,
hey guys, what are you
instead
doing
of texting Mike, we'll just text Kristen the whole weekend.
Oh yeah, there you go.
Super.
Mike, I'm in my robe. Cooking bacon today.
I got a recipe for some nice sauteed balls. Actually, that was from Dad today.
Oh yeah, the cooking with testicles cookbook or something.
It was a real book.
Rocky Mountain oysters, right?
I'm sure they're delicious.
Have you had balls?
Please,
before,
please do not ever serve those to me.
If you slice them thin enough.
You've never had lamb fries?
Sure.
You put them on some focaccia bread.
Egg batter,
bitch,
I
turn off.
Yeah. Oh, it sounds delicious.
Does it turn off? Should be a brand new.
The heater just went out.
Brand new.
It's gonna it's gonna drop down from 45 degrees to 38 degrees in here any minute.
Feels warm, but it's
tough.
It's a brand new bottle.
Yeah, it's actually not too cold outside, but we just got a nice blanket of snow.
It is pretty cold out there. It's in the teens.
Is it?
I would think so. No,
it's like 30.
It's 30, yeah. 30-something. Yeah.
Hey, nothing was melting.
Okay.
Yeah.
This thing sucks.
Terry?
Yeah.
What is the temperature tonight?
Oh, I got it right
okay,
here.
Okay, I will say 22 degrees.
Plus or minus 1 is what you get.
22.
No. Close. No.
19.
I got 27 degrees here.
27?
It's colder than 27.
Well, that's what it says on the thingy here. 27 and cloudy. Feels like 18.
Oh, but see? That's what I was going by.
I'm just listening.
Such a Jesus.
Such a bunker.
Yeah, in the bunker, it's a nice balmy 41 degrees.
I just...
And a bunch
plus
of
or minus.
And a bunch of propane fumes.
Yes, and cigar smoke.
These poor motherfuckers that download this and take up their dad on their phone to download this.
Hey, these poor motherfuckers are our listeners. Love you.
They're our loyal listeners.
All six of you.
Like Lexi. Lexi stopped
arguing about what
she stopped sending.
Kenny,
any new
countries listening in?
You know what? I can check that out for you, Terry.
And ask Lexi why she doesn't tweet anymore.
I will get into that momentarily.
Since you seem to have a close connection with her.
Login required.
I think my humidor is too humid.
Oh shit! Brian's on the way back.
It probably needs to be humid because it's super
dry.
These
are going out too fast.
You got to pull Darling right now.
Oh, the 7-2, 7-2. Maple Leafs are crawling their way back.
Let in two.
Well, now we stopped playing defense. Yeah, that's the problem with the Hawks all year long.
Tell the defense to giddy up. Let's see. Stats. Show stats.
Countries. Botswana.
Episode show Geographic. Here we go.
There we go.
And
is that thing out?
Yeah.
The heater?
Well, it's not stand. The pilot's not stand lit.
Wonder why. So probably we've all, got the United
probably
States.
Probably all the beer I spilt over here.
Yeah.
Put out the
it's
fucking
a douse,
plane.
Right.
We've got the United States, Canada, China, Germany, France, UK, Netherlands, Finland, India, Ireland, Australia, Sweden, Japan, and Philippines.
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 Wow. Fuck all you naysayers.
We got to get South America.
Yeah, I will not rest until we get South America. South America.
Well, your goal is
we can
Dominican Republic.
No, we can expense a business trip down there for promotion purposes. We can get on radio shows.
There you go. Mike, your goal is one download from the Dominican Republic.
I will do that.
I have a friend in Norway. Pull us in.
Does that count?
Get him to download.
Yes, Kenny. That Norway is a country.
No, I'm trying to figure out.
Which
Finland?
State is Norway in?
That's the state of hockey.
I think it's in Minnesota. Is that up in Minnesota?
What is our number two country in listeners?
It is Russian. Huh?
What is our number two country in listenership?
Canada.
Tennessee.
Ding, ding. What is our number three country in listenership?
Didn't we already have this conversation?
Ding, ding.
Right.
What is our number four country in listenership?
United Kingdom.
Germany.
Oh.
United States.
Germany.
Germany. Wow.
German girls.
What is our... There are four countries that I mentioned that are tied for last.
Tennessee.
Philippines, India, France, and...
Botswana.
And what's the other one that you just mentioned?
Philippines is the only one you got right.
Oh. I mean, there's more than one France, a French download?
No, France is way up there.
Whoa.
Syria.
France. Bonjour, mon ami.
Parlez-vous français?
Yes.
Can I write off my... I'm serious. I'm
the
thinking
West
about
Bank.
Flying there. Can I write it off?
They play
Syria?
The business
where to Syria?
Yeah. No, France.
Okay.
Wee wee.
That's where Cristobal Huey is from. That's where
maybe
Antoine
he's listening.
Roussel. He's probably... Yeah, he's...
Philippines, Japan, Sweden, and Australia.
Mm-hmm. Highest paid Swiss player in ever. He's probably collected the Blackhawks money for a couple of years.
Can't figure out.
I
got to
get some Grease downloads.
I can't figure. Yes, you do.
Yes, I do.
Yes, you do.
I can't figure out where this Tanzania one comes from.
That's
or Tanzania.
That's Africa.
Only two from Ireland.
Folkers.
Air Folker.
No, yeah, that's.
That's Mal.
Technology? Let's see, technology. Does that show us? That doesn't show me.
Well, Dan, your goal is to get more listeners for us.
Right.
Yeah. Since the four of us can't.
It's clear that
we... there's Lancaster.
So I'm in charge of new business.
You are
in charge
of new business.
He's our new business. He's our lead marketing guy. Right.
Director of procurement.
Right, new business. I like it. You're hired.
You know how Wayne Messmer works in my building?
Does he?
I rode up the elevator the other day with him.
What's he do?
He's got Wayne Messmer Enterprises, I think.
Where's that? Your attic?
Yeah.
No.
What is he? Office. Does he still own the Wolves?
I think he's part owner. So.
Yeah, I think he is. He sings the national anthem most times.
What's that then?
Doesn't he have like a gunshot wound?
He was shot
to
in the
neck.
He got shot, yeah.
Why?
Taylor Street.
Yeah, it was
on the way of the game, right?
It was by Chelly's Chilios or whatever.
That's back when the neighborhood around the UC wasn't very nice. You know, where the guy who sings the national anthem, the beloved guy who sings the national anthem, gets shot in the neck by a guy trying to rob him. Something, right? Didn't he? It's like a carjacking or something, right?
Yeah. No, they came up and just robbed him or something and shot him
through
the window.
It had to be 15, 20 years ago, wasn't it?
It's not that long, but it could be.
It's over 10. I know that.
Yeah.
Well, he took over the Wolves during the lockout, right? Is that when he sort of doubled down on the Wolves when there was no hockey to watch, and the NHL was locked out and nobody gave a shit about the Blackhawks, and the Wolves all of a sudden took off in popularity.
But again, that had to be 15 years ago.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Was more than that.
Did Mike say something stupid in episode 3?
I would say yes.
Because we peaked at episode 3, and 4, 5, and 6, and 7 have all been a little bit down. Oh, that coincides with you not drinking. The fans want a drunk rookie Mike. Lighter,
if you don't mind.
We want a drunk Mike. We just don't want you spilling everything over.
I'm trying not to. I'm itchy.
You want a straw?
Yeah.
Please. He's itchy.
I'm itchy.
I brought my own rubber band.
We should document what I drink for each episode, and I bet it correlates how good it
is. How about another shot?
All right.
I mean, I'm kind of curious how things have gone down since I've been kind of the hang-arounder guy.
Well,
no.
You know what?
I'm not a fully
no.
patched member yet, but...
Sure you are.
You know. Oh, you're in.
No, because Mike's not fully patched yet, but you guys keep working on it. But you know what? The listenership went up when you went into the hospital. Everybody's tuning in to find out how Sailor Dan's doing.
It's the human drama. It's that.
Did he go south of the
equator?
It's the
human interest story.
I don't
about,
know.
Dan,
you were a full member when you said, hey, can I hang around with you guys? Sure, no problem. You're in. As long as you pour the beer and the shots.
Sure. Kind of head, doesn't that?
It's a little sick today.
I think we got a bad wire. Oh, there's America's Wang. I mean, I told
I'm
him
I'm over-modulating today.
He's going to have to... Here, is there
about ready to throw the computer
just
away.
Just a teeny taste, that's all.
Problem
that's
is the outro that, needs to go.
That's good. Just want a little taste. Thank you.
See, that's not going to be good. The outro is going to be bad. I'm going to have to do the old outro.
That's fine.
Tonight. Yeah.
Thanks for listening to the...
Yeah?
Yeah, there you go.
I'm going to do the old one. We're going old school today.
We got some problems.
We got a Buffalo Trace?
We got some technical difficulties.
That's all right. That's all right. We'll have to improvise. Like we used to do in the old days of podcasting.
Fuck yeah. Mike, to your banana hammock.
Yeah.
And to the grape smugglers.
The grape smugglers, the banana hammocks, and the...
Have a good time.
I'm going to try. Hope I come back. That is very, very good.
The Zinca?
It is very good.
Sammy Sosa, we said hello.
Yeah.
Baseball so, now, where are you staying down there?
Punta Carta.
Punta Carta.
I know. Is it... all-inclusive?
Yes, he said it was. You want to catch you up next from last week?
No, I really don't.
It's all-inclusive. It's just him and Kristen. They're going down.
I do know that.
They're going to hold hands. They're going to go to a nude beach. They are going to rekindle the same cornfield wedding they had in Belvedere.
It'll be like a sugar cane.
Yeah. But
hey, as long as there's a combine, they'll be happy.
Oh, yeah.
21 shotgun.
Yeah. And Michael had diarrhea down there.
Where's the moonshine?
Moonshine, motherfuckers.
You know, that is something I'd like to do.
What, moonshine?
Yeah. Just make a little bit for the podcast. White lightning.
I have a still. My parents have some. My brother has some back home.
I can make a still. Yep. The secret is to not blow up your garage, though. That's why they stick it out in the woods.
I've got a bathtub.
We've been back here for 2 years and haven't blown anything up.
I'll tell you
yet.
What. Yeah. I'm on season 4 of Moonshiners, so I think I'm almost there.
Yeah.
I think with the other knowledge that you've got and what Mike,
I can't believe there
has
actually been 4 seasons of Moonshiners.
Oh fuck! It's a good show.
It is a good show.
Really?
You just need some clean water.
Yep. Good, cold, clean
and a lot of
water.
Sugar.
Water,
sugar.
And a little dog.
You know what? They were one. Yeah. No, it's cutie. Cutie pie.
A little dog.
Which is what I named my dog.
We'll bring Cody out here, my dog. He'd be a good moonshine dog, I think.
The other secret, or one of the episodes, they were making actually George Washington's bourbon. Recipe handed down.
You can buy that. We talked about that last year on the show. You can actually buy
the recipe.
Yeah, they're making that again in Mount Vernon.
Oh,
it's like $150 a bottle, and supposedly it's just horseshit.
Oh, really?
Because it's just straight off the still.
Yeah, it's like
it's moonshine.
That's a
I would rather have Buffalo Trace.
Yeah.
Buffalo Trace is almost like the Southern Comfort of
that's fine.
I like Southern Comfort too. I'd rather Moonshine is
Moonshine is this week's.
Yeah,
I want something that's about 7 years old.
Uh huh.
In an oak,
I threw up on
in an oak barrel.
So many times.
Listen to fucking Terry. It's going to be 7 years
no,
old.
Well, just, the reason why you put it in a barrel for 7 years is so it doesn't taste like fuel anymore.
It was rags.
What's the matter?
What are you doing, Mike? You all right?
Good.
You spill
Did
again?
Did you spill something again?
Nope, just not going to paper towels.
Yeah. Thanks, Uncle Terry.
Oh, you gentlemen are very welcome.
Harry.
Yeah, so we're going to have to get the full report when you return to see if you, you know.
Oh, speaking of full report.
Yes, Kenny.
We've got a full report.
Oh, good. A full report. Yep.
That's horrible.
Yeah, that's a full report.
Sure, good job.
I forgot that.
I can throw some snaps at you.
Fucking computer.
Is Mike going to call in when he's out of town or what?
No,
you'll be back. You'll be back.
Will you leave a message? Take your phone. Leave a message on the voicemail.
Take Kristen's phone and leave a message.
Oh, yes.
I don't even know the number.
you do have business cards.
I have Kenny's. I have my own business cards.
Yeah, I gave everybody. I'm going to have to make Dan some now. Once he gets a mic. He's quarter patched. Once he gets a business card, he's half patched.
Mm-hmm. Once he brings a bottle.
Mm. You brought a bottle once.
Yeah, you did. You're okay. You're in.
He's brought lots. He's brought stuff. Absolutely.
No, I brought a bottle to your birthday. Has nothing to do with the podcast.
Oh, just bring
that was Yacht Club. That was a different
Yacht
Club.
Just bring yourself. That's all we want.
Yeah, Yacht Club season. I got to clean out.
What are you looking for?
What happened to the American flag? We don't have the American flag in the background. Well, that's not right.
I had to use the ladder.
We always we got the American flag as a backdrop.
Well, we got the real fit Depends.
Yeah, and the Jeremy Roenick jersey.
And we got the Greek dude.
The guy staring
scary
at me.
Greek dude.
The
Greek dude is judging us right now.
Again, he's staring right at me.
Yeah, well,
staring at you with disgust.
Yeah,
look at your blue coat.
I swear to God.
Dan, you missed some good Greek judging last week when Kenny
got kicked out of my house.
That's because Terry didn't shovel his fucking sidewalk.
Oh, it's my fault.
So I track in a little bit of snow.
No, I tracked in mud all over the house. Him out of there.
There was no mud.
It was on here last. She walked in here last week.
Oh yeah. No, if you listen to the podcast, you'd know.
Oh, fuck, I'd kill us.
It was funny.
I get yelled at so much that it doesn't even faze me anymore.
We'll share this fucking thing. Sorry.
You both have to speak into it. See, that was fine.
Meet at the middle.
Yeah.
It's like
it'll be like a...
Lady
and the Tramp with a...
with the spaghetti.
With the spaghetti.
Yeah, like David Bowie and Mick Jagger.
Well, we did those duets that one weekend.
We got to do that again. Have you ever been on the Bacon and Hockey YouTube channel?
Negative.
You will have to.
Oh
be.
Man, it's huge. It's huge
channel?
In China.
We're gonna be. You will after tonight.
We're gonna be on. You can listen. You can see and listen to the whole show.
I did go on the Facebook page today, though.
Oh yeah. Oh, I think I saw that. We got a new listener. You got to call Bob Stock again.
Mm-hmm.
I told him he posted something today, and I said, yeah, the Bacon and Hockey podcast sent you that weather. They're like negative, you know, or zero.
Do you have to have Facebook to look at our Facebook page?
Not if it's open to the public.
I think it is open, isn't it?
It should be open to the public. I can't imagine why we'd be exclusive about that.
Oh, ours should be.
Very exclusive.
Ours should be.
It's very
damn
private.
It, you better be on Facebook to see us.
You know, I'm a little apprehensive on saying anything because I know it's being recorded. And I'm kind of like,
nobody listens.
No, I
except
can,
in China.
I can bleep you out.
Yeah, we can edit it back out. Yeah,
if you say something incriminating, don't worry about it.
When one of you guys decides to run for senator, then we'll start editing.
Speak your mind, Dan.
You start drinking Buffalo Trace and you say shit.
Yes.
There you go. That a boy. Open up.
No.
We're here for you.
No. Come on, Dan. What do you want to say?
Your colon itches?
Michael Scratchit.
There's shit you could say about a lot of things.
Yeah.
Like what?
You don't want to be public.
Oh, this could be Sailor Dan segment. Go for it, Dan.
What do you want to do? What do you want to say?
Editorial.
No one listens.
No, seriously. You can change people's minds.
No, and that's great. And I could have something prepared.
Yeah, you'd be the only one.
Yeah.
Because I gotta be a first of this show.
I could totally do an editorial.
Yeah, there we go. All
right.
What Frost Sailor Dan's propeller?
What the?
And you could come out with
a barnacle
underneath the penis is just a fucking painful thing.
8 inches.
Yes.
It scratches, it itches, it feels stops. Good all in the same wrapper.
Send a bunch of guys to scrape it off with.
I need to bring in more stories, too. I used to do this one, you know, odd news.
Yes.
No, I mean, the fans have spoken.
I'm rooting for you, too. It's, you guys are cute together, really are.
fucking guy. Seriously.
Come on, I'll buy you beer.
Speaking of beer, Dan, you want to grab me another one, please?
Yeah.
While you're at.
Oh, boy.
Light if they have one.
Yeah, there's a couple down there.
There's a lot of different beers in there. There's one right in the top there. Oh, Dan's like, he's strapped in with, got cables and wires. It's like a, it's like
I get you...
I drank it, Dick.
There's more in here.
I'll take a light.
Here. Then
yeah,
I'll drink
here,
these.
Take that.
Sit down, Dan. Right?
Isn't that High Life Light good? It's better than Miller Light.
I haven't been here in a fucking month. Anything tastes great. I mean, I could be drinking fucking big flats.
Right. Bold Adventure. I'm drinking Big Butt Doppelbach.
I got a case of big flats for $3.
Oof.
It's horrible.
Yeah, it is horrible.
Big flats? Yeah, that's not good.
Oh, I'm buckling over.
Yeah,
that's the Walgreens beer,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yes. Oh my god.
Yes.
It's not even cheap, is it?
$1.99 for a six pack.
It would have been my college beer.
All right, maybe I'll start drinking that.
Jesus.
You still drinking the Ice House?
Let's,
no. You and I haven't had Ice House since May.
Let's do a test. You drink some Big Flats and we'll see how you smell. I guarantee it destroys you.
I'll tell you what we need to redo.
Destroys you.
We need to redo Black and Tan.
Oh, that was a good night.
Bacon,
I don't think
Hockey,
I've
Black
for some
and
reason,
Tan Theater.
I got super, super drunk.
That was
that
when Mel was
that's
when
because I wasn't drinking and I was fucking serving them
that
up
to you
guys.
Mel was
you
here too that night.
Did.
What's that?
I mean, you got super drunk. You don't know why. It's because we mixed everything with Guinness.
Well, I mean, I'm just saying.
Boddington's
you know,
was
Guinness,
good.
Guinness isn't very heavy.
Guinness
no,
is
but
is
we
only...
mixed it with everything. Then we have like.
Oh yeah, well we
but
probably
I mean,
we
I,
had black and blue.
Like,
we had
I
mean,
fifteen
yeah.
fucking
cow.
Beers.
It was a good time.
The Boddington's with like the honey whites or something
was
good. Really good.
All of it was good, but I mean, I think we ended up drinking like 90 beers.
It's
yeah.
because I wasn't drinking and I was bartending, and I just served the fuck out of those to you guys.
We had Shiner Bar. We had Black Shine.
Yeah.
Why were you drinking, asshole?
I had that was on that gout medicine or whatever the fuck it was.
That's
you're
just
a pussy.
That's not even real.
My foot hurts.
I have gout. Fuck that.
It's
I had gout.
Probably
too.
Got a
you know
ingrown toenail.
That's a recommendation. It doesn't mean you have to. They just don't want you to drink any time.
You feel
medication.
So stiff with gout. Why doesn't it happen in your dick?
I bet you if you had gout in your
okay.
dick, you'd be...
That's so...
no more porn!
It's stiff. No, but
that
it's,
would be good for the show.
It's stiff but painful. Why would you want your cock hurt that hard? To see Dan
it would
laugh.
Swell.
Like this shit.
It would
like,
swell. The wife wouldn't appreciate
come
it.
On. Swollen.
Oh, Terry, you're in tonight. It's
all right, show's over. Come here. Come inside the house, Kenny.
It's the first time I felt you... Since our first night.
Yay. Terrence.
Hey, that Greek guy's staring you down. Don't fuck with
no
him.
No fucking shit. Look at me right there. And he's got his hand on his fucking dagger.
I presume you washed your hands. I ain't touching those headphones.
Talking to you.
You're urine is sterile, Kenny. And that's a...
It also has a lot of nitrogen, and you can put it on your crops.
And it's
that's
also
right.
really good if you want to harden up your hands.
Yeah.
Moises alu.
Piss on his hands.
Moisture alu.
What?
For jock itch. Is it good for jock itch?
It's good for athlete's feet.
How do you pee on your jock?
And golden showers.
Just pissing your pants.
Just aim straight up.
Hold on, I got jockage. Or come to
turn the fan off here. You're ruining my stream.
You'd be like Kenny at one of our drafts.
So wait a second now. So Moises Lou used to piss on his hands?
Yeah, to make his hands hard.
I bet you his mitt smelled terrible.
Did you see Two Guns? Two Guns is a great movie. Speaking of movies, I got to bring that up. But Two Guns is a great movie with Wahlberg and Denzel. Mm. And the Mexican guy pisses on his hands before he grabs the bat to beat the shit out of him. So it's good for Moisture-a-loo.
That's right. Didn't you see...
Went to see this weekend. I saw Hail Caesar. Hail to Caesar.
Yeah, what did you think of that?
It was very bad.
I heard it wasn't good. That's too bad because I really liked that, the Coen brothers.
They all had a gas making the movie.
Yeah.
They loved it because Channing Tatum's doing this fucking tap dance that looks like Fred Astaire.
Yeah.
You know, all this crazy stuff. But it was out there. It was way out there. I checked out for probably 45 minutes, checked back in. When it ended, I went, seriously? Wow. It was a little bit out there.
But, I
caught Blazing Saddles.
That's good.
And this weekend.
I was on HBO. Very close to showing that to Michael.
Oh, you have to. But you know what?
Jimmy's probably, I'll wait a little bit for Jimmy.
Do you know what's funny is I saw it when it was in the movie theaters in 1973 or 74 or whatever it was, 72. That whole bean scene was hilarious.
Yeah. Oh, around a campfire?
Yeah, yeah. Not quite as funny 50 years and 30 or 40 years later.
More beans, Cookie. You fellas have had enough.
No, exactly.
Who was Mongo? Was that Alex Karras?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was Alex Karras. Yeah, Mongo. All right.
What do you want it for?
Shut up.
Rape, robbery, and rape. You said rape twice. But I like rape.
Yeah. He's like...
Mongo just a pawn in the game of life.
Shut up or the Negro's going to get it.
Yeah. He's walking himself out.
Yeah. Don't shoot it. I think he's serious. He's just crazy. Help that man. He's just crazy enough to do it. See, you got to watch it again. Watch it on the airplane down.
I've seen it.
The wife will love it.
Just put porn on the way down.
No, I've seen Blazing Saddles.
No, on the airplane.
Banana whopping.
On the airplane.
He's got the spyglass out.
On the airplane, just put a porno on.
Bing, bing. Everybody, it's a bing.
Did you pied yourself down?
No, I'm not.
No, he sport Bill. He sports some beer.
I shorted my thing out.
Well, if you guys are going to share, I'll turn you up a little bit. Just don't speak right into it.
What?
We'll have to
put it like that. So
we'll have that for Yacht Club night.
Right, Dan? There we go.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's better.
There you go.
Sibilance.
Just don't
swear.
Look at the golden pipes on Dan.
Golden pipes.
Golden pipes, he with no colon.
Well, he's got some of his colon. Just a little bit.
Yeah, while you were in for your procedure, Mike's over here Googling colon removals, and it's got like these big fucking
huge. Looks like burritos. Disgusting. Like big ones. Like not like even bigger than TBK.
Was it a chorizo burrito?
Oh, might have been.
Laurie, after the hockey game on Saturday, can we stop by Taco Burrito King?
TBK.
Hell yeah, Papa.
Beep. So we just came from Greek islands. We ain't stopping.
The Greek islands. You know the problem with those Greek restaurants in Greektown. You know, they're the west side of Chicago. For all the people in Germany listening, all the restaurants are exactly the same, and they all taste exactly the same, and it's all. Like,
They've got some different things.
It's all mediocre.
Bronzino.
Oh, no. I like Greektown.
No.
There's a Greek restaurant in Schaumburg right there on...
Oh, it's on Gulf Road.
Is that
golf.
Any good?
It's okay.
Mykonos is good.
Mykonos is good. Then
golf
place,
in Greenwood?
Golf in Palm Grove or some shit.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah. Yeah. I go there.
There's supposedly one right on Tui, just over the Edens, which is supposed to be very good, too.
It's called Pisistrata.
Yes.
That's supposed to be really good.
Hysteria or something?
Something like that. And Lori went, she was saying for like her sweet 16 birthday or something, they went to that. It was at least a restaurant with the same name. I'm not sure if it's the same one, but it's right there. The one on golf that you're talking about in Schaumburg, Mike, a Greek guy took me there. So if a Greek guy takes you there, it's got to be okay.
Dan, yeah. This is your wheelhouse.
Oh, have you been to Boston Fish Market?
Yes.
Over here in Des Plaines.
Des Plaines, yeah.
You want to talk about Greek and you want to talk about seafood and you want to talk about good.
It's good there?
Wow. Yeah, decent prices. Decent prices. Like I'm not a big seafood guy, but we went there because the lobster roll was on.
If you don't mind the... it's kind of unorthodox in the way
it's
you
not a restaurant.
And stuff like that.
Yeah.
They just bring out these huge platters of brilliant food.
And they got a couple
right
of
there,
tables.
Right when you...
It's behind the...
They do a wholesale.
West Hawaiian Sunday. Place.
They do a wholesale and a retail business, and they have this little
it's
restaurant
right by the Walgreens, thing. Right?
No.
Oh, right
where's this
Aldi?
It's on a dead end. It's on
Manheim.
Lee.
Right.
Lee... You know where the driver's license place is?
Where Manheim
take a
ends
right.
Right there and it turns to Lee?
No, it's before that. Where Aldi is on Lee Street? On Manheim?
No.
Yeah, do you know where there's a Wendy's? The driver's license
right
place, there used to be a Hobby Lobby. You take a right.
Yeah.
It's one block, one stoplight north of Oakton. And you go back into a dead end back in there, and
it
is a retail place,
Boston
a commercial place, but then they also sell, and then they have some tables. And the Chicago's Best, I think, went there and said that they had a great lobster roll.
Look at a great
area.
We
went there.
Anything
it's pretty
order,
good.
I'm
not
surprised
a big seafood
that Christina
guy.
Doesn't know about it. Cause they're
she
Greek,
probably does. I just don't pay attention to her.
I mean, and they're right
okay,
there.
Okay, yeah.
And it's so cheap.
Yeah.
And I mean,
yeah.
I go there on Saturdays to buy fish retail, and it's so cheap. And I used to buy for the restaurants from these guys. And we did business for probably a good 6 months, and we had some.
I do have a question about your restaurant. Are you guys also glazed and confused? Or
glazed
part
and,
of it?
Glazed and
infused?
Yeah.
The donuts?
Yeah.
Those are fantastic.
Yeah, they're good.
It's like $3 a donut, though, isn't it?
Yeah, or four, depending on the
Do you ever have those?
No.
Oh, they have the...
but they're huge, you know? I mean,
they have the one with the bacon on top?
Oh,
the long john with the bacon?
Long john.
Oh, my God, is that fucking good.
Now, I remember when the boss came to us saying, I want to do these donuts, and they're going to be, you know, almost like a Trump. They're going to be huge. They're going to be... And he's explaining, I'm going... We're never going to get $4 for a donut.
Yes. They bring them into work every now and then.
And
we'll,
all of a
we'll vendor bring them in.
We're getting $4
God,
and people
just,
are calling us. And,
we just
and
slice those things
they
up.
They can't get enough of the donuts. And, you know, that's why he's the boss. I mean.
So you eat at this place? You can go in there and eat.
You can go in there and eat, yeah. But you need to go there early.
No, yeah.
I mean, because.
And during the summer,
up.
They got tables outside.
Well,
you
and,
sit
and
out
all,
the umbrellas.
Like, well, right now, because it's all inside, it's communal seating. So
yeah, and it's like.
Can
what
you get
do they
shit
got?
To go, though?
12 tables
you get a
in
number,
there, maybe?
It's like you order before you sit down. And
yeah.
It's kind of a weird thing.
Yeah.
Can you get it to go, though?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
But I wouldn't
no,
recommend
it. No, it's a good
it.
Place.
I wouldn't recommend it. Seafood doesn't travel well.
I mean, I'm taking it, like, I'll immediately eat it.
Dan, can I stop
I
you right
eat
there?
With people.
We live nowhere near a sea. They must travel somewhat well.
Yeah.
I mean, come
no,
on.
I, mean,
I got
cook,
a good point here.
Cook seafood, no.
Come on, hang on.
Cook
hang
seafood.
On, hang on, hang on. I got to this. I deserve that.
No.
Yeah.
Once it's cooked, though, it. No.
You got to, yeah, you can take the frozen stuff or the uncooked stuff.
I don't think,
even,
I think it's fresh only. I don't think they freeze
well.
Stuff
but
there.
But if you take a look at fresh seafood, it's just being grilled. And they just do the Greek thing with the herbs and
the oil,
right? And they do it
Why
on
do you
got to
get all
in? And it's really good. It doesn't travel well.
No, you got to eat it right there.
Right, yeah. When it's hot. And,
yeah.
And it's, I mean, it's so good. The place is so good.
That's the way Mike cheap. Used to treat dance clubs back in the 80s. Got to eat it right there.
Right on.
Yeah.
On spot.
Don't get home.
Boston Fish Market, y'all.
Ladies and ring,
no,
the,
that's,
ring
oh, wait,
the bell, Kenny.
Wait, I got
to. Are you turning to Kenny?
Yeah, I guess so.
There we go.
Nice.
Double clock.
I don't need a sound effect. No, I heard that on, hey, it was Chicago's Best when we went there this summer. And it's like a, it's got a lot of favorable reviews. It's good stuff.
It's good. And if
parking just... blows, the you know, it's not a restaurant. It's not a date night thing. It's place where you go and
but
go
I mean,
get
you said
it,
it's good in the summertime. There's a place to eat outside.
Oh, yeah, there's tables outside. But
it's better in the summer.
It's well, there's well, more availability.
There's more seating in the summer.
Yeah, but I'll tell you what, it's packed. It's packed. I mean, it gets...
Always. I mean, I try to get there before lunch or dinner time when I just go there to buy retail because I'll go there to buy fish to cook at home, right? Because it's really good fresh fish. They sell wholesale or whatever. So they bring in their stuff from wherever, East Coast, West
what
Coast.
What time do you get in, though? Go get it.
I mean, I'll try to get there by 10:30.
Oh, shit.
Before the lunch rush.
I'm going to make a rut. Yeah. I carry a cooler in my car for work. So.
Yeah.
If you're there,
have some pharmaceuticals.
First,
let me push the fish to one side.
I got the fish in here. I got my, my shit.
Everyone's so concerned about the customers and the restaurant side is they forget about the people that are trying to buy retail, right? Like, I just want 2 pounds of whatever, Chilean sea bass or
sea bass.
Whatever.
Oh,
you can't
so
tell
good.
If you get a good Chilean sea bass. Though.
I mean, I got oysters there on New Year's Eve. They were beautiful. I mean, they do a good job. Their calamari's good. I mean, they got good stuff.
It's all above Kenny's head.
It's all good.
Yeah. Is it better than deep fried?
Yeah, can we
no? Okay, forget it.
Well, he's from Wisconsin, right?
Does it come with tater tots? No? Forget
can
it.
I eat it with can I eat it with cheese curds?
Yeah,
love the schmelt.
You know, Holtz is
how much is
some
it?
Good cheese curds.
They got great cheese curds. Yeah.
So, you know, the Wisconsin Restaurant Association, their motto is if you fry it, they will buy it.
Yeah, that's true.
Cool.
On food stamps.
That's it. Especially up there in Manitowoc.
Manitowoc, right?
Yikes.
Why do you gotta make it sexual?
What? Jesus.
Can just
Manitowoc?
Fuck, can I say?
Come on, you're from Wisconsin. You know where Manitowoc is.
That's where.
Don't get arrested
look at,
there.
Look at Jack enunciate.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You gotta
it's
give
Manitowoc.
Manitowoc.
I mean, subtitles. Subtitles on Wisconsin people. That's kind of.
That's why you have to explain everything carefully. To,
I mean, seriously.
You have to sweat
slowly
it a few times to Kenny.
Yeah.
We're talking about right now, Kenny.
Hey.
Of course, I will have some cops custard this weekend.
Mm-hmm. Don't get pulled over, though.
Why?
Cops is the worst joke ever. It's fucking horrible. Cops
custard. Seriously? You got it like that. Nobody else did.
No,
you're. Oh,
I've been sitting next to you for 2 years now.
I just drive home like.
Yeah. God bless.
This podcast sucks.
Worst podcast ever. You got to pee again?
No,
you gotta
not,
pee again?
He's nauseous for us to banter.
I'm gonna grab it.
You're gonna grab a what?
Yeah, he's got one of his.
He put it on the TV cooler over there.
Yeah.
Do we have any more whiskey?
No, we're out.
No, oh, no, gone. There's a.
I got a bottle of Jack inside.
No, there's
want to grab
Jack
that?
Right here.
Sure.
There's Jack right there.
How much is in there?
Hang on,
there.
Terry. Where's the. Hang on. It's number 9.
That bottle right behind you. Jack. Is there anything? There's nothing there.
Yeah, there's
Kenny.
A little in there. That's good. Yeah.
Here, Ken, shut your mouth. Here, drink this. Shut your mouth and drink this. Out of the bottle. Fuck it.
Yeah.
No, it's for
take
you.
Take the governor out of
you're,
there, Jack.
You're on vacation.
We don't use governors anymore.
Yeah. Yeah.
You'll be drinking rum.
Rum, yeah. There's some good rum in the Dominican Republic.
No, just rum on the rocks. So squeeze a lime.
Oh, yeah.
That's all you need.
We'll kill it.
Beautiful.
Drink it before I spill it. Drink before I spill it.
No, drink it.
I don't
you deserve it. You're the one flying. You're the one on vacation.
I rented 2 movies for the plane.
Django Unchained.
Yeah. Yeah. Almost as good. Straight Out Compton. And Spectre.
Oh, okay.
You go,
I haven't
Dan.
Seen that yet.
I want to see. I never saw that one. It's got Christoph Waltz in it, who I like. Is there anything that he's in that isn't good?
Oh, no.
Have you guys ever seen? It's a,
oh, he's the guy from Django Unchained
and
the German guy.
Glorious
yeah, he's
and,
good.
And have you guys ever seen The Green Hornet with Seth Rogen?
No.
He's the bad guy in that. It's actually a funny fucking movie. If
you did
like,
you see A Million Ways to Die in the West?
No. I haven't.
What's that new that new superhero movie?
Deadpool.
Out I heard that's like brutal.
Brutal bad.
But I mean,
it's
they're like
be horrible. I've never heard of it. Isn't Deadpool a Clint Eastwood movie?
It used to be.
Directed. Yeah. Directed. Or acted.
No, it used to be Deadpool. It was the.
It was like it came out in like the early 80s.
So yeah, late this douchebag Deadpool. I'm not watching that shit.
But
they're trying too hard to advertise it.
But they like advertise for kids and like. Everybody's like, don't bring kids to this movie.
It's supposed to be like a rated R Marvel movie.
It was on Adult Swim, and they're like, no, Comedy Central, and they're like, we're not during work. You guys ever watch Workaholics?
Yes.
Okay, hilarious. They're like, we're gonna present Workaholics without commercials.
That's what I call
where
Kenny.
All the commercials.
Workaholic.
Were Deadpool, so it's like sponsored by them. It's horrible. The guy I do like is that
let me
JT
check.
Miller. Yeah, like him. You know what I'm talking
about. Which one is he? Is he the guy with the long hair?
The hair is.
Yeah.
Kind of.
Let me look.
He's
the,
in.
Let
Silicon
me look
Valley.
This up.
Pretty good.
Okay.
You seen that?
Which one?
Silicon Valley. You ever watch that?
No. I hear that's good too.
It's hilarious.
WWW
Silicon
Valley.
Yeah.
They're so douchey. It's hilarious. Douchey.
Dan, just leave it on the table. I'll dump everything out during the week.
Yo, sure. Just like I cleared off all the bullshit from last week.
I'll go in here until next week.
There's shit on this table that's over a year and a half old.
Yeah, good. That's the way it should be.
It's just
horny goat weed for water.
First of all, it adds to the show, Michael.
Give Mike another drink.
I have one.
No, let's do a shot.
Shut your mouth.
Let's do a shot for Mike.
I don't need a goddamn shot.
Terry, go get some Jack.
Shot. Right. I don't need it.
Terry,
don't get it.
Terry, go get it. I'm gonna
actually
tell you,
send Kenny in there to go get
let's
it.
Let's ask the crowd. Do you want Terry to get it?
No.
It's unanimous.
You don't need to ask Terry twice.
He'll go get it.
He's getting old.
Take your goddamn shoes off, Terry!
You know damn well he's tracking in snow.
Yeah. That's why you should have gone in there. Kenny, you should have gone in there. Christina Terry says that so here to get the Jack Daniels.
Okay.
We drank all the Jack Daniels in the garage. We need to get another full bottle.
Hi,
okay,
Christina.
I'm so glad you came in.
It's
tonight.
Ken.
Hi, Ken. Hey.
I like the tankini you have on. I'm just here for the Jack Daniels.
Yeah. Oh, I'm so glad you came home early tonight, Terry. I'm ready. I'm just here for the Jack. Fuck you, Terry!
I don't
fuck
smell
you in your goddamn podcast.
I don't smell alcohol on you like I normally do. Come here.
No, that's a lie, though.
Yeah.
Of course, I can hear you guys. I can hear you guys in this fucking sunroom.
What? We didn't say anything.
Fuck you, Terry! Fuck you!
Terry, is that you?
See, that happens when you leave the room.
Oh, scoot in.
Gosh. It's the highbrow humor we're famous for here at the Bacon and Hockey Podcast, ladies and gentlemen.
I think I figured something out. We need to start this podcast about 45 minutes later than we do.
Probably.
And then start recording.
Yes, yes.
I think we tried that a few times.
Well, yeah, that's probably not a good idea.
Yeah, I do need...
The intro would be all fucked up.
It was already.
Yeah.
The whole podcast is fucked up. Who the hell cares?
You gotta speak to Mike like you're on a date with him when you talk, Dan.
I don't think so. I mean, he's a good looking guy, but.
See, we can hear you when you look at Mike deep in his eyes.
My lady.
I mean, Kristen's just as swept off her feet.
You're fucking ain't right.
Get the fuck away from me.
How could you not be? How could you not? All right, fine. Give me a little more.
I still can't. We drank a whole one of those every podcast.
Last year.
Well, we almost We almost did that last week.
The first 2 years we did for sure. I mean, every podcast.
Yeah.
Now you guys are a bunch of...
The first year was just beer. Second year,
last year we had a bottle of the weekend.
Yeah,
that was
the fourth year of the podcast.
Yeah, do you guys remember when I found that like that bottle of Canadian Club in my wife's grandfather's garage with the seal on it and everything? It was like a 1973 bottle of Canadian Club, and it wasn't evaporated. It was pretty good actually.
Did you see Las Vegas?
No,
with
Vegas.
Yeah, Morgan Freeman, Michael Douglas.
No.
No.
There's two other guys, but they... Oh, and not Pacino, but...
De Niro.
Robert Redford.
De Niro. And they, at 10, they stole this bottle of white stag whiskey.
Silver stag. Glenfiddich Silver Stag, yeah.
And so they stole it when they were 10. So then they went to Vegas when the guy's like 70. Douglas is getting married to some young piece of trim, and they bust it open. They all take a sip out of it because they saved it for 60 years or whatever the fuck it was. Yeah. They all just gagged. It was horrible.
The Holy Grail of Scott.
Silver Stag. I want some Silver Stag.
Yeah, it was from...
I've tried it.
I love it.
Very good.
Look into Mike's eyes when you talk.
Is it good?
It was good.
I do have a bottle. I do have a bottle of... Do you ever have a Oban?
Yeah, I love it.
Yeah, that stayed in there. Yeah. That's not coming out for the podcast.
No. When your boys get married or something, you drink that.
I had a Silver Stag in Philly, and it was at a restaurant that I worked at. We had a huge scotch collection. We had over 250 different single malts. And I quit, came back.
Quit what?
I quit working in this place.
You quit and hit it.
And then I went back there as a customer, and a friend of mine who was still working there was like, you know, it was late night.
After hours.
Okay, wow.
Oh, so.
Yeah, let's hit the Silver Stag, you know. And we hit it. And we were already drunk at that point.
Is that code for something?
Red Stag, let's hit it.
No. And unless you're from Wisconsin, it's not.
Right, yeah. That's Beloit talk.
Yeah.
Well, that's why I've had like Johnny Walker Blue, and it's good, but it's...
Yeah. But that's the
blend. At a buck 20 a bottle?
It's a blend. Right. I mean, it's very
I'm
good.
It's good. I'm
a fan of it.
But I could have mentioned it.
I'm still a fan of the Lagavulin. Mm-hmm. I like the really peaty shit. Mm-hmm.
Oh, not Tullamore or Dewar, but there's...
Well, you gotta try to go... Well, you have Oban at your house, right?
Yeah, I have Oban.
Yeah, is that the Lafroy? That's a real peaty. I love. See, I'm a big fan of that.
Yeah.
It's not. It's trash bag it's boy. Very smooth.
Too much for me. Yeah.
You like it?
Good luck on your trip.
Mm-hmm. I fucking need it. Good luck.
I'd rather have that good, like Caribbean rum.
Oh, that
a
the agricole.
I don't think I'm gonna get any of that on an all inclusive.
You see, Mark? Did you see Mark? Did you see
rum will be your best bet?
Did you see Mark and Jeff?
What kind of rum, then?
No, just whatever they're pouring. Just ask for some gold rum and squeeze a little lime, maybe a little bit of soda water or something in it, just a splash.
Mm-hmm. The gold rum.
And some colon.
Right. And just,
right.
And just
garnish it with a colon.
I don't like
smoke a lot of pot.
But see, I don't like spice
mushrooms.
Rum.
No, it ain't spice rum. It's like, it'll taste like caramel. It'll taste caramely if you have...
I'm a more of a Bacardi.
Well, who brought the... Captain who brought
Morgan.
The... Did no, it's when we had,
had Kraken.
No.
It's cold. It's just aged.
Not Dave.
It's good.
Well,
didn't Jeremy? Jeremy
oh,
bought.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
Jeremy
yeah.
bought a
in
bottle
cast,
of rum, and
right?
that was
yeah.
really
yeah,
freaking good.
I forget what that was.
Remember Jeremy last year? He brought the bottle of rum.
Yeah.
Dan, did you see that Mark and Jeff are making Ridge Runner rum?
That was a big, big fat hot sauce. He bought the bottle of rum. That was
Moonshiners. Mark and Jeff are making a Ridge Runner.
That's after before I had to drive him home.
Yeah, those two guys don't.
After he did a burrito on
him. Oh my God! Were you there? You were there.
He's like this.
Yeah.
Oh, your burrito, man.
Oh, that was a TBK.
Yeah, that was good.
Terry's driving. We're hungry.
What happened?
Post podcast.
Where's
the burrito?
Bring him around. Have him bring some more hot sauce for us.
TBK sucks. Place sucks.
He sent a picture the other day.
It's
on
good,
Facebook.
Like it's good.
It's terrible.
No, it's not terrible.
Matter.
1 o'clock in the morning, it's fantastic.
I'd rather go.
Nah, you've got a 5-star tongue. You need a beer tongue.
You know, Wisconsin.
When it comes to that,
beer tongue.
TBK.
I made some nice short ribs yesterday.
When you're hammered, and it's 2 o'clock in the morning. It's
I'll eat TBK for lunch.
In the sheet pan all day and.
It's good. It's still good.
It's good for the digest. You know what? You maybe have a better colon
that's
than
right.
that than you got.
Yes.
Right.
That's why you got a blockage.
His colon is very refined.
I remember when I got my
Well, what's it called? I got my shit done. The
gallbladder, appendix.
No.
Hysterectomy.
I got tied.
Hernia. Oh, your nutsack cut.
You got tied?
What's it called?
On my phone.
Vasectomy.
Vasectomy.
Yeah, yeah. So I had the piece, and then my wife went out and she got TBK, thinking, no, I'm gonna give him something he really likes, and she got the brutal fucking big. It wasn't good.
That's a good one.
This is you laughing, right?
No, it's good. You gotta speak. You gotta look in deep into Mike's eyes.
What is it?
That's you and your
hockey jersey.
Rookie Mike's for the listeners at home. Rookie Mike's showing a picture of sexy Tony as
your Mike's birthday. Go show it to the camera.
I gotta get up. Oh shit.
Boy! Oh,
it's on his phone.
It's fine.
It's official. He's one of us.
It's a hot corner over here.
Get the paper towels over that
you've
side.
You've earned
of
your.
The garage must slope that way.
I'm gonna have a dispenser on my fucking stand.
That, you know, I feel so tied to this.
Yeah, you don't have much room over there.
Yeah,
you lost your stripe. But you are now official.
This is the new indestructible droid. Fuck y'all.
Mm-hmm. Remember when Sailor Dan first showed up?
It was like it was yesterday.
And we're
about 4 weeks ago.
Or 4 weeks
and
ago.
And then we were looking for him.
We
Dan, where where's your colon?
That's that rag.
Yeah. That's Towley.
Towley.
Yeah.
You two having fun over there?
Yeah.
Oh man.
Now we're just reminiscing back in the
How we doing on time there, Kenny?
Oh, I'm sure it's time to quit.
We're way over time.
All right. Surprisingly.
All right, let's
surprisingly, we're
like
over 35
time. 35 minutes in.
You know, I told some coworkers about the podcast and there's one guy, our IT guy who
I noticed
kind
a spike
stuff
in
like this.
Listenership.
And he looked it up on iTunes. He's like, "Holy shit. That's a long podcast.
They've been around for 4 years."
It's been longer than 4 years, hasn't it? I feel like it's been...
Jack, you listen to it on public transportation. Sure. What is it, a down and back trip?
Yeah.
It's a down and back trip.
Yeah. For me, yeah. Because it's about, yeah, it's down, yeah, right.
We've had a couple marathons.
Well, this one's working on it.
Well, should we read our standings here?
I would do it really quick.
Now, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Number 11.
Thanks for listening.
And number 11, Brewmaster James is one nut. Buckhead's at number 11. Number 10, yours truly.
Fuck.
Still coasting along the bottom.
Fucking 10.
At number 9, we have Sexy Terry's Kill Whitey. At number 8, climbing up ever so slightly, Downstate Wade's Double Minor. At number 7.
How could he be ahead of me?
He must actually be paying attention and doing stuff. At number 7, we have Don't Taves Me. At number 6, we have Jim and the Punk Monkeys. At number 5, all the way from Punta Cana, Dominicana Republica.
That's a big move.
Yeah. At number 4, Mal, Sega 69ers.
Fuck,
Mal. Screw him. Number 3, Minnesota James, Rink Rat.
Now, who's number 2? Who's number 2?
At number 2... our very own Professor Ken. And number 1.
Number 2.
Number
That's a
1
great turnaround.
A, hitting the top of the charts with a bullet, Steve and the Meatballs.
Yeah, we should get Stevie in here.
Yeah.
So we beat the shit out of him.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Kenny, that doesn't sound good.
Oh, it's fine.
Are you calling? That sounds like a phone call.
No, it's an air horn. We're going old outro, too.
All right. Well, let's wait till Dan comes back. We'll go to our outro.
Excuse me, we're fucking podcasting here.
You doing okay over there?
Jesus Christ, that's not even fit.
Yeah, Mike's on YouTube. Hey! Look at the dogs.
Hey, yeah.
No, either way,
you got dogs swimming.
Have you ever seen what a Great Dane can do to a chick?
It's a donkey. I'm watching donkey shows.
Oh, boy.
That was a good one.
The Hawks win 7-2 tonight, ladies and gentlemen. A brilliant victory over the Toronto shitball.
Who scored,
Maple
Jackie?
Leafs. That would be everybody scored. Kenny, let's find out. 7 goals.
Kane, Panarin, Kervainen.
Panarin, hang on. We'll find out tonight. Well,
Seabrook.
On. Johnny Taves, I believe, scored a goal. All right, hold on. Let's get to the stat tracker. All right, we won that one. Who? Let's see here.
You're right there, Mikey.
Jesus Christ, has he drank?
No.
Is this
no,
the first
time? Mike's in his own little world over there.
Drink up there, Hawk.
He's having a good time. Let him leave him alone. All right, here we go. Come on, Hawk. Give me the box score. Give it to me. What are you watching over there?
Mike spit beer up through his nostrils.
Yes.
Yep, that worked.
Yes, 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 yes.
My bad.
Let's get some box scores.
All right, let's
wrap put a fucking bow in his who bitch and get out of here.
Who took all my hold business
on, cards? Tonight
there's some right there.
I need him for the Dominicans.
Other side of the mixer.
You know what,
Presidente?
I will give you a little heads up, a little teaser. This episode will be posted on Facebook.
All right.
Yay.
And on YouTube.
All right, tonight the Hawks scored Brandon Machinter, his third goal of the night, his first.
My
Shinter?
I hope he wiped.
Second goal, power play goal, Andrew Shaw. The third goal, Brent Seabrook. The fourth goal, Artemi Panarin. The fifth goal, Patrick Kane. The sixth goal, Toivo Teravainen. The sixth goal, Victor Svedberg. Wow.
Who's the number one star?
Hold on.
You got seven different scorers tonight?
That's it, yeah.
Kane.
Kane scored twice?
No, he had
Yeah, Svedberg, Toivo Teravainen, Kane, Panarin, Seabrook, Shaw, Machinter, and a couple guys for
that's
the,
a good game.
Arcobello, who's nobody's ever heard of for Toronto, and Pierre Alexander Parenteau for Toronto. The three stars of the game are the third star of the game is Patrick Kane. The third star of the goal is Scott Darling with 37 shots against.
That should have been number one.
Number two is Andrew Shaw. Number one star of the game is Patrick Kane.
Because why?
I'm not sure why.
He had a goal and like 18 assists.
Yeah. Yeah, he had him.
He assisted on every goal.
Three assists, one goal. Andrew Shaw, one goal.
Fuck. Speak into the mic, Mike.
He got
speak
4 points. Jesus Christ.
Andrew Shaw got one goal, two assists, and Scott Darling with his pretty decent game there. And
just missed a shutout.
And a kick-ass fucking save.
He played very well. That's it, friends.
Thanks for listening to the Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
Okay, turn it up, Kenny.
Brought to you by Ringside Heating and Air Conditioning. Serving the O'Hare Corridor and all of the Chicagoland Northwest suburbs. Visit our website
at
ringsidehvac.com. Ringside Heating and Air Conditioning, your comfort champions. Be sure to visit the Bacon and Hockey website at baconandhockey.com and follow us on Twitter at Bacon and Hockey.
And Facebook
also,
at Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
Join Bacon and Hockey Podcast on Facebook.
Oh, there it is.
You can email us at the following email
Don't
addresses.
Forget about our YouTube.
Jim@baconandhockey.com.
The Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
Jack@baconandhockey.com.
At YouTube.com.
Ken@baconandhockey.com.
Mike@baconandhockey.com.
LeatheryManSack.
Jim's got baconandhockey.com.
We got to get Dan.
Right here.
Bacon
on the Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
Kenny, if you wanted to call and leave us a message,
847-242-1571, Jackie.
Call us and leave us a message.
Enjoy.
Which, Mike, you better do when you're down at Punta Cana.
Enjoy your Punta Cana.
Thanks for listening to the Bacon and Hockey Podcast.
That's it, ladies and gentlemen.
Pause that bitch. It's still recording.
People are just
They cannot wait.
They're queuing their car right now.
They cannot wait.
They cannot wait.
They're just driving in circles. Like, when is it going to be posted?
Oh.